if...
All right. Are you familiar with the email problems we've had with Donald Jr., Donald Trump Jr. in the last few days?
I have not, Senator. I've heard that there is an issue, but I've spent the last few days meeting with your colleagues, so I missed that.
This is an email sent June 3rd, 2016, by Rod Goldstone, who's apparently someone connected to the Miss Universe pageant and has ties to Russian entertainment, to Donald Jr. Eamon, just called and asked me to contact you with something very interesting. The Crown Prosecutor of Russia met with his father, Arias, this morning, and their meeting offered to provide the Trump campaign with some official documents and information that would incriminate Hillary and her dealings with Russia and would be very useful to your father. This is obviously very high level and sensitive information, but is part of Russia and its government support for Mr. Trump, helped along by Arias and Eamon. What do you think is the best way to handle this information, and would you be able to speak to Eamon about it directly? I can also send this info to your father via Rona, but it is ultra sensitive, so wanted to send to you first. 17 minutes later, Donald Trump Jr. replied, "Thanks, Rob, I appreciate that. I am on the road at the moment, but perhaps just speak to Eamon first. Seems we have some time, and if it's what you say, I love it, especially later in the summer. Could we do a call first thing next week when I'm back?" Should Donald Trump Jr. have taken that meeting?
Well, Senator, I don't, I'm hearing for the first time your description of it, so I'm not really in a position to speak to it. I gather that Special Counsel Mueller
would... Well, let me
Mueller
ask you
would...
this. If I got a call from somebody saying the Russian government wants to help Lindsey Graham get reelected, they've got dirt on Lindsey Graham's opponent, should I take that meeting?
Well, Senator, I would think you'd want to consult with some good legal advisors before you did that.
So the answer is, should I call the FBI?
I think it would be wise to let the FBI
know. You're going to be the director of the FBI, pal. So here's what I want you to tell every politician. If you get a call from somebody suggesting that a foreign government wants to help you by disparaging your opponent, tell us all to call the FBI.
To the members of this committee, any threat or effort to interfere with our elections from any nation state or any non-state actor is the kind of thing the FBI would want to know.
All right, so I'll take it that we should call you, and that's a great answer. Now, this is what Don Jr. said Saturday before the email came out. If I can find it here, this is his statement about what I just read to you. It was a short introductory meeting, and I asked Jared and Paul to stop by. We primarily discussed a program about the adoption of Russian children that was active and popular with American families years ago and was since ended by the Russian government. But it is not a campaign issue at that time, and there was no follow-up. I was asked to attend the meeting by an acquaintance, but was not told by the name of, was not told the name of the person I would be meeting with beforehand. Do you think that's a fair summary of the contact between Donald Trump Jr. and this Rod Goldstone?
Senator, I don't know what would be a fair summary. I don't know.
Would you agree with me this is very misleading?
Senator, again, I don't have the full context to be able to speak to
it. I want you to look at it and get back with the committee and find out if that was misleading. Is Russia our friend or our enemy?
Senator, I think Russia is a foreign nation that we have to deal with very warily.
You think they're an adversary of the United States?
In some situations, yes.
Do you think in the situation of trying to compromise our election, that's an adversarial move on their part?
Yes.
Do you believe the Russians did it when it came to the hacking into the DNC and Podesta's emails? Do you believe the conclusions?
Well, Senator, as I said to your colleague,
do you have any reason to doubt
it? I have no reason to doubt the conclusions of the intelligence.
Would that make you a good candidate to be an enemy of the United States?
I think an effort to interfere with our elections is an adversarial act, as you said before.
Comey, did you see the press conference he gave about the Hillary Clinton investigation in July of last year?
Not live, but yes.
Would you have done that?
Well, Senator, there is an Inspector General investigation into Director Comey's conduct.
I'm not asking about the investigation. I'm asking about you. Would you have done that?
I can tell you that in my experience as a prosecutor and as head of the criminal division, I understand there to be department policies that govern public comments about uncharged individuals. And I think those policies are there for a reason. I think they're important, and I would follow those policies.
Okay, he talked about somebody that was never charged in a despairing fashion. Do you agree with that?
That's the way I understood his comment.
Do you also agree that he took over the prosecutor's job by saying there's no case here?
Well, Senator, again, there's an Inspector General investigation into his conduct.
You would not have done either one of those, is what you're telling this committee. At least I hope that's what you're telling this committee.
I can't imagine a situation where, as FBI director, I would be giving a press conference on an uncharged individual, much less talking in detail about it.
You say that Mueller is a good guy, right?
That's been my experience, yes.
And you'll do anything necessary to protect him from being interfered with when it comes to doing his job?
Absolutely. I think he's a good guy.
Do you believe that in light of the Don Jr. email and other allegations that this whole thing about Trump campaign in Russia is a witch hunt? Is that a fair description of what we're all dealing with in America?
Well, Senator, I can't speak to the basis for those comments. I can tell you that my experience with Director
Mueller... I'm asking you, as the future FBI director, you consider this endeavor a witch hunt?
I do not consider Director Mueller to be on a witch hunt.
Thank you.